sunshine.
The Fenway Park special. Now, remember, Red Sox fans living west of Boston will be able to commute by rail to Fenway Park in April. Fans are calling for trains to arrive at the Fenway platform 20 minutes before the game.
Hey, Joe? You all right? Look like shit.
Well, at least my socks match.
Yeah, well, I had to get up early.
Oh, shit.
What'd you do to your head?
I don't know. Somebody hit this place?
Mind if we look around and see?
Yeah, go ahead. Where'd you get that asshole for a partner?
You know.
Hey, well, look, has been. I didn't throw my partner through a plate glass window trying to protect some beaner in the act of committing a felony.
Beaner? Beaner was unarmed.
We had a rap sheet longer than my dick.
Never been arrested, huh?
Go ahead, laugh. I'm not on suspension. I'm not the one living on food stamps.
So listen, Joe, you got a problem. Jake Farley's dead.
Great. He was a real scumbag.
Somebody slit his throat with a wire.
Got any leads?
Everything's been slow for you since Dwight busted your ass.
Well,
how you fix your money, okay?
Great. Just a cigarette.
You know, I never agreed with what they did with you.
I'd like to help you out, King. Whoever I swore did us all a favor.
This your shirt, Paris?
No, I take in laundry.
Yeah, it's my shirt.
The cuffs. I found it behind the refrigerator. There's something else.
Having trouble with your garbage, Joey? We found your name in Farley's pocket.
This is a setup.
Joe Paris, you are under arrest for the murder.
Knock it off.
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to speak to an attorney.
Yeah, I know it.
Come on, he knows it off by heart.
You have the right to have an attorney present before any questioning. If you cannot afford an attorney, one will be appointed for you without charge by the court. Do you understand each and every one of these rights I've explained to you have?
Easy,
take it easy.
It's over for you, Paris. You're finished.
All right. Don't do anything stupid.
Public Defender's Office, man.
Some asshole jumps off the Tobin Bridge with Jake Farley riding a rope.
He's been after that sleazebag Farley for years. Some guy should get a medal for saving public funds. The trouble is, the guy's a cop. He just put the make on Joe Paris, who most of you know.
Obviously.
Joe's on suspension, so this case is going to draw a lot of heat. City Hall just called and laid it on us. Who's going to be the lucky guy?
Well, here we go again, girls. Who's the lucky guy? By the way, guy is spelled A-S-S-H-O.
Rabbits, you and Samson have the most experience with a ship. Which one do you want it?
Wait a minute, Bradigan.
What's your problem, Hudson?
My problem is my last three cases for the postman bitten by a poodle, some first-time grass smokers, and a derelict knocking quarters out of a parking meter.
Come here, Bradigan. Look, ladies in the office, get every shit detail.
Bradigan, I've been here for 2 years, and I want this case. I am better than Kravitz or Samson.
Oh,
the defendant is entitled to better than one of your old poker pals defending him.
You know, Paris really deserves one of these broads, Brannigan. It's a great way to get rid of the hot.
Pretty tough on us to put our heart into keeping Paris out of jail.
Come on, Brannigan. Bring one of these burnout hacks on the case. It's a travesty of justice.
Hey, Kravitz, do I look like a burnout case?
Oh, you do look a little gray around the
All right. Hot stuff, you better deliver. Because my tail's going to be in a crack for not putting one of the old pros on this.
I am better than one of your old pros.
Yeah, from your mouth to God's ear.
Wow! Got it!
15 minutes, Joe.
Joe Paris, I'm Jennifer Hudson, your attorney. I'm extremely busy right now, and we only have a short time, so... let's get started. Tell me, what happened last night? You do talk.
Where's Meyer?
Mr. Meyer took a corporate job. Don't worry, I'm smarter than Meyer. I got you.
I didn't know I was so popular.
Oh, you're a celebrity downtown. You don't find many liberal cops these days.
Well, yeah. Is that what you think I am? My partner shot an unarmed man. I just nudged him, Will.
You nudged him through a plate glass window. And 6 months ago, assaulting a police captain? You realize your history of violent assault does not make our case any easier, but I can help you.
Who dresses you in the morning?
Be nice, Mr. Paris. Remember, your ass is in my hands. Tell me about last night.
There's something very strange about a wealthy chick like you. Defending a trickle-down case like mine sounds dangerously like a hobby. Public defender wearing a Rolex.
Your insecurity is not my problem. The watch is a gift from my fiancé.
You don't wear a ring?
Real detective. I got the watch instead.
Send me somebody that works for a living.
Fuck you, you arrogant asshole!
Nice. It's my asshole, lady.
It's my career.
Oh, I'm sorry. How'd you get to be a public defender anyway?
I got a late start. I blew 5 years in the Peace Corps.
Perfect.
I don't want the courtroom experience.
Yeah, well, get it with somebody else. You don't know anything about me, lady.
Yes, I do. I know you're a cop accused of murder one, you have a violent temper, and you have a history of problems with authority. But I can get you off. The minute I don't shine for you, you can fire me, but I'll be damned if you're going to pass on me because of the way I dress. That's not me. This is me, guts and brains. You cannot do any better.
Dear God, a faster version of Tarzan.
Fine. I was getting you out of here tomorrow. Your bail bondsman friend, Elmar Frazier, agreed to put up bail. He says he owes you, but if you're not interested...
How do you know Delmar?
I do my homework. Now, should we talk about last night?
Sure. I don't remember.
Don't stonewall me, Paris.
I'm not. I got drunk. It's happened before. I passed out.
You don't remember anything?
No, nothing.
Who had reason to kill Farley?
Lots of people. He had lots of things on lots of people.
Did he have anything on you?
No. Friends of mine.
You knew him?
Yeah. Well, he was a snitch, you know. I used him on busts.
How well did you know him?
Just to shake him down a little when he got out of line.
What do you mean, shake him down?
Well, slap him around. I never heard him.
But it would be correct to say you had several violent physical encounters with him over a period of years.
I guess so.
And on more than one occasion, you threatened his life in the presence of witnesses?
Yes.
I'd say you do.
Miss Hudson, I've done a lot of shitty things in my life. I've never killed anybody.
See you tomorrow.
What?
You arranged to have a psychiatrist interview your claims?
Yes, I have, Your Honor.
That's the man with Tom Farley. He was on a bottle of Valium at the time. Doesn't even remember stopping his car on the bridge.
Can you find another razor?
No.
This doesn't surprise me. What have you done now?
Delmar, I think you've met Miss Hudson.
Only over the phone. Pleased to meet you.
Likewise. So, I hear you two go a long way back.
This dude saved my life.
Here with nothing.
Listen, Joe, you skip bail on me, I lose my house. And I just put a hot tub on my deck, you understand?
I fail to see the wisdom of granting bail in a first-degree murder case. Community safety is the priority here.
Your Honor, Joseph Paris has lived in this city all his life and intends to remain here. Mr. Paris has no prior arrest, Your Honor. He has protected this community for 14 years as a police detective. We also feel, Your Honor, that our case is strong. It is in my client's interest to exonerate himself by showing up for trial. I feel there is no risk that he would not appear.
What does the district attorney's office think about that, Mr. Nix?
I concur with Ms. Hudson that Mr. Paris is well known to the law enforcement community in Boston. However, that the seriousness of the offense calls for a sizable cash bond.
I'd like to add that my client was locked up last night with men he has sent to jail. There isn't an institution in the state where Mr. Paris would be free from reprisals.
I can do without the dramatics, Counselor. You've made your point. Mr. Paris, bail is set at $500,000 with surety or $50,000 cash.
Your Honor, we are prepared to post real estate with equity of $50,000 if that is acceptable.
Mr. Nix?
No objection, Your Honor.
Very well.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Hey, I hope you realize that I took it easy on you in there. I didn't have to let your guy walk.
You did the right thing.
No, I did the expedient thing. I don't want to sensationalize this case any more than you do. Well, let's do us all a favor. Let's clean this guy. I'll give you a good deal. I've got the guy named.
We'll find out in court, won't we?
You are new at this, aren't you? Oh, did I tell you they've got Paris's blood type on a murder weapon? Yeah. Just came back in the lab. Hudson, right? I'm offering you a deal. Now, don't drag your client through this. Try yourself.
See you in court, Mr. Nix.
Is this supposed to jog my memory?
That's the idea. Do you want to stop?
No.
Do you want to see where the body was found?
I usually don't like people from a lot of money, but of course there are exceptions.
Put that away.
What?
Put that away. Don't like that.
You can't be serious.
Not in my car, okay?
Okay.
Look familiar?
Farley's bar? Of course it looks familiar.
You've been inside?
No. You? Never.
When was the last time?
I don't know. A month ago. 2 months ago. Yeah.
Nice place.
Oh, yeah, real nice. Up to their ears and hookers, and they got enough cocaine, they just got to get this.
Are you Joe Paris?
Mm-hmm.
I have a message for you from Mr. Farley.
Mr. Farley?
My son.
Mr. Farley says, fuck off. He doesn't want you in here anymore.
Is that what he said?
Joe. It's not worth it, Joe. Let's go. Joe. Before we even went in there.
Yeah, so what? Do you believe this putz?
His father only died 2 days ago.
Not exactly in mourning, is he?
Maybe Matt's a suspect.
He hasn't got the balls to kill his old man.
Who hates you enough to frame that Joe?
100 names? I'll tell you a list in the morning.
What?
What
do I think?
Let's go.
Don't say a word.
Bed early?
I'm beat, honey.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I don't want you working too hard, okay, babe? So how'd it go today?
I had a rough day.
Yeah? Why?
DA wants to make a deal.
Nobody ever made AG by plea bargaining.
I don't want to be attorney general.
You will.
No, I won't.
Yes, you will.
I think Paris is guilty, Kyle.
So? That's why he's got you. This case is good for you, Jenser. Really. You want to join me?
I can't.
Guess who sold $20 million in double B bonds today?
What?
I'm getting the boat. You know the 41 footer?
When are you ever going to have time for sailing lessons?
I'll make time.
On your schedule?
I'm a can-do guy.
Why did you call me before?
I tried, but you were out. I ordered you a cellular phone.
I don't want to sell your phone.
Jim, we don't communicate enough. We need a cellular phone, okay? This one's black. It's sleek. Press one button, you're talking to me. You'll love it.
Can we talk about this later, honey? On the phone, you saw Joe Paris and I September 23rd?
Yeah, that's right. We had a party. Joe was here all night.
You sure he was here all night?
You're damn right. Me and my dog drove him home when we closed up. on account of the bump on his head.
And what time was that?
4 a.m. Yeah, that's right. See, because I always take away their keys. The big drinkers, anyway. Of which Joe was definitely one of. But I tell you one thing. Ain't no way Joe would have made it home that night. Passed out cold. Sorry.
How did he get them? The bump on his head.
Some asshole got loud. Started pushing this woman around. So Joe put this guy down. Joe's a fighter.
Who was the man he hit?
Never saw him before.
You don't know his name?
No.
Or the woman?
They came in together. They weren't regulars.
Joe's pretty hot-tempered, huh?
Yeah, but Joe ain't no killer, though. I mean, this folly was a walking execution waiting to happen. Folly had this reverse Midas touch. Everybody's life he touched turned to shit.
This was 4 nights ago. Why didn't you call me sooner?
Hey, I read it in the paper yesterday. I called you.
Will you testify that Joe was here that night?
Yeah.
Thanks, sir.
How'd I do?
You did just fine. I'll let you know when the trial date is set.
Sure thing. Thanks. The bartender's lying. He sounds coached.
You're just trying to intimidate me because your case is falling apart.
No, my case is airtight. I have got motive. I've got method. I've got the murder weapon with matching blood.
That's because Joe is framed. We've got the alibi.
Paris put this guy up to it. A lot of people owe him favors. Your alibi is a fabrication.
Prove it.
I will.
In the meantime, you won't mind calling up the tale you put on Joe and me? It's illegal.
What tale?
A few nights ago, a cop was hanging around Farley's. When I spotted him, he took off. Then yesterday, a cruiser followed me to Lewes and then back here.
Because then I'm out of the car?
No, and I didn't get the man's ID either. He was following me, not interviewing me.
I didn't authorize that. We don't do that.
And you won't mind undoing it.
The bartender is lying.
Hey, sure you want to come? We got a private bus to the garden. All right. I'll bring home Chinese if I forget.
Have fun.
Jenny Hudson?
That's right.
My name's Deborah Quinn. I need to talk to you. It's about Joe. My husband doesn't know I'm here. He doesn't know I know Joe. Do you know who Vincent Quinn is?
DA talks about him.
No one ever makes anything stick to Vincent.
So it seems. Interesting. What are you so afraid of?
Joe was with me the night Farley was killed.
Where?
At my house. Vincent was out of town. It is not what you think. I got involved with Joe shortly after his wife died.
That was 2 years ago.
That's right. Vincent and I were going through some rough times. This kind of rough. The night after he did this, I went to Farley to have Vincent killed. $10,000 up front, another $10,000 afterwards. But I couldn't do it. I called it off. Farley wouldn't give me my money back. He played me a tape of my meeting with him. And he said that if I didn't pay him, he would play it for Vincent.
So Joe fixed things with Farley.
I don't know how, but he got my money back.
How far would you go to repay an old debt?
What do you mean? Would you commit perjury? I didn't have to come here. If my husband knew that I was here, I'm telling you the truth. Joe was with me the night that Farley was killed. Can I call you if your phone is off the hook?
Oh, yeah?
Why don't you give me that up?
Hey! It's your car, lady. This is my apartment. What the hell's the matter with you, anyway?
I met Deborah Quinn tonight. She said she was with you the night Farley was killed.
Yeah, well, she's making it up.
Is your bartender friend making it up, too? Nick thinks so. The whole world is turning out to commit perjury for Joe Paris. Joe, this is a murder trial. You have people lying for you. They will destroy you. You coached him. You spent the night with Deborah, but you couldn't use her as an alibi. And Lou owed you a favor, just like Delmar did, right?
What are you getting so worked up for?
Tell me the truth, Joe.
It was easier to talk to Lou. You know who Deborah's married to? Have you got any idea? If she takes the stand, he'll have us both killed.
There was no blackout. You spent the night with Deborah.
There was a blackout.
But you spent the night with Deborah.
I don't remember. I'm not bringing her in on this.
She is your alibi, Joe, if she's telling the truth.
I won't need an alibi if we find out who did it.
Right now, you are the prime suspect. Joe, I need to know everything about your relationship with Deborah.
Why?
That woman had the oldest motive in the world for killing Farley. If you're involved with her, that gives you the same motive. I need to know what went on, or the prosecution will take us apart. Are you still lovers?
No.
Then she's lying, too. She said she was just with you.
Well, what's going on? How could that conceivably be good news for the bond market?
It's very perverse. The Japanese will come in and buy our bonds.
It's weird. Does it worry you as one who wants rapes historically?
Everything worries me. You know that.
are you a buyer, a seller, or just a fretter now?
I'm neutral on rapes, and I just follow.
I hope you save me some.
The trend lately has been most of the things, so I cut back into stock market.
Turn that down a bit, honey.
Would you be surprised if the market was up 100 points next week? No, I would not be. I think we're...
I was watching that.
What's the matter with you?
I told you I was going to bring home Chinese food after the game.
Looks like you ate it all, too.
Where the hell were you?
I went to see Joe Paris. We're having problems.
Well, I thought we were going to spend some quality time tonight.
Okay, let's go.
It's too late. I got to get up early.
You were being infantile.
You went to the house of a murderer.
I went to the house of a client.
You said yourself he's guilty.
I never said that.
I just thought that we were going to spend the evening together.
You went to the ball game, Kyle.
That was scheduled, and you know it. I was back here at 10:30. I didn't know where the hell you were. And now I find out you were the murderer in his house. I suppose he tried to put the make on you, huh?
Knock it off.
He did, didn't he?
He did. Get out of my face and thanks for the one dime egg roll.
Hey, there's another spare in here. You want it? Huh? Take it.
Shoot. You missed.
You're a jerk. Oh, God.
Nobody would cover and nobody would do this. Just get the guy on the phone and tell it to him straight. I see your bartender's off the witness list. I was right, wasn't I? Postpone.
I'd say you both had enough enemies. It's just a matter of time for something like this happens. Just be glad Farley ain't the one that's being framed. Here's my desk.
You're all hard.
You know, you never should have left this place. Those guys downtown play a different ballgame. So, don't move around. If anybody sees you here, you tell them you're working for me. Hi. Tough break. You're Joe Paris, right?
You'd feel kind of silly if I wasn't, wouldn't you?
Listen, I hate to see a fellow officer in trouble. They get a cop by the balls, they squeeze. You need all the friends you can get.
You got something to say, say it.
All I'm saying is that cops got to stick together because nobody else gives a damn. Nick Anthony, deceased.
Sure.
James Columbus, deceased.
Dear God, this makes me feel very old. All my enemies are dead.
License 83.
And all of them.
Paul Lance Lewisburg, Harry Norton, parole 87. Matt Darby, blind.
Wait a minute. Harry Norton? How did he make parole?
Good behavior.
Good behavior? I sent him up 11 years ago on conspiracy to commit murder.
What's the link to Farland?
There is none. Where is he now?
Norton Fish, please hold. What do you need?
Harry Norton.
He's getting his tubes cleaned in Brazil. Norton Fish, hold, please. Honeymoon. He married Tanya.
How is Tanya?
Well, she married the boss. What more could a girl want, right? Norton Fish, hold, please. I love it when I get a whole line of blinking lights.
So he married old Tanya, huh?
Oh, I don't mean the mother. I mean the daughter, Tanya Jr. Oh, the old lady was pissed. But what could she say? I mean, she was after his bucks, too. Now she gets him without all the hassle.
How long have you been away?
Can you believe 3 weeks? Norton Fish, please.
Well, I've been on hold for 15 minutes now, you know?
I told you, please hold. You hang up, you go to the end of the line.
I bet he wanted you. Good to have you.
Well, I really wasn't interested. I mean, I could never fall for a guy whose hands always smell like fish.
Maybe she worked cheap.
Are you kidding? She got a raise every time he closed the door.
You wouldn't happen to have an itinerary around here, would you? I mean, I'd like to send him a wedding gift.
Mm. They'd love that. But nobody's supposed to know where they are.
Mm-hmm.
Rio. I did the paperwork myself. 4 weeks in Rio, left second week in September.
I'd like to take it to Rio myself.
Oh, yeah? Mm. I'm free.
I'm not. I'm wanted for murder.
Don't you just hate when that happens?
Hello, Joe.
Already?
I told you, I didn't want to see you again.
You mind getting off my car?
What for? I like it here.
Afraid you might fart and the garlic would peel the paint.
That's funny, Paris. Nothing could hurt this ship.
I'll slow around my car, pal.
Yeah? You're up in murder one, Paris. You better watch that temper of yours. Asshole.
Police brutality. Do you find anything troubling in a policeman using his office unfairly, say, to commit a crime? How about you, sir?
Well, the police can go too far, sir.
And you, ma'am, how do you feel about police brutality?
I think the police have a hard job, and they're in danger a lot.
And you, sir?
I think she's off his list. The guidelines of the law, the same as any other citizen.
And you?
I think the police are killers.
Killers, right?
Mr. Bastianelli, can you really tell me with all conviction that you believe someone is innocent until the prosecution proves them guilty? Or do you sometimes feel you can tell just by looking at someone whether he is guilty or not?
Sure, a guy might look guilty, but I'd keep an open mind.
Mr. Bastianelli, have you ever had any experience with a police detective? Been followed by one or questioned by one?
If I have, he must have been a good one, because I don't think so.
Doing here? He's in the house.
You went to see my lawyer, didn't you?
I had to.
I want you out of this.
But I'm in this, Joe. Your lawyer said that I don't have to say everything. We could have been just friends.
You gotta realize something. You get on that stand, that DA's gonna rip you apart. And then Vince is gonna find somebody and rip us apart. Tell me what happened that night.
We got here about 10. We drank until 3 or 4 in the morning, and then you went home.
Well, how did I get this cut on my head?
So?
Where?
Here.
Where?
Yeah.
What happened that night?
What do you remember about that night? But you remember coming here?
No.
You had been drinking before you got here. And when you arrived, there was blood on your shirt and a cut on your forehead. You said you'd been in a fight. What are we going to do?
I don't know. I just thought I want you out of this, okay? Okay?
Okay. Very beautiful.
Yes, she was.
Would any woman marry a man like Farley?
Money and power. Of course, you wouldn't know about things like that.
I suppose you prefer animal men, doesn't it?
Yes,
Jenny,
I do.
Can I offer you and your friend a complimentary after lunch drink?
Yes.
Yes.
No. Well, whatever she says.
Thanks anyway, Louis. I've decided to put Deborah on the stand.
We had this discussion.
We have no choice.
I don't want her on the stand.
She's your only alibi,
Joe. I don't give a damn. You're concentrating on the wrong person. What about Norton?
You can smoke if you want to.
I don't want to smoke.
Norton and Farley had nothing to do with each other. Norton was out of the country at the time.
So what? All we had to do was make a phone call.
We still need a link to proceed on Norton. There is no link. What about police officers? Did you have enemies on the force?
Lots of them.
Great. Anybody like you?
Just you.
I feel like I'm working blindfolded here. Why is that?
I don't know. Maybe you don't trust me.
Where are you going?
See, you don't trust me. Hi, Harry. How was Rio?
Just great. Be right with you, honey. You're Joe Paris, aren't you?
Yeah.
Get lost.
How's honeymoon?
Wonderful. Well, what do you want, Paris?
Talk to Jake Farley lately.
Farley? I haven't seen that bum for years.
Somebody put a piano wire around his neck.
Yeah, so what? Scum was always a loser.
So I'd like to ask you a couple questions.
Yeah, well, talk to my lawyer, will you? I've got a good one now. Listen, Paris. I'm out of jail now. I got a new business. I got a beautiful new wife.
Harry, let's go.
I got a good life now.
Harry, come on, honey. We'll be late for the decorator.
Nice to see you again, Paris.
Could anyone else have murdered Jacob Farley? Answer is no. There are no other suspects. This murder was committed by one man, the defendant, Joseph Paris. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, during the course of this trial, the state will prove beyond reasonable doubt that Joe Paris brutally murdered his longtime enemy, Jacob Farley. The loving father and sole support of two young people, Matthew and Amy Farley, then cruelly displayed his contemptuous deed by dumping the body on the Tobin Bridge for all to see. We will show that the defendant had the means and the motive and the opportunity to kill Mr. Farley. We will show that Mr. Paris is a dangerously violent man who cannot control his temper and who has been suspended from the police force for unwarranted violence. We will show that he had a long history of violent association with the deceased and threatened his life many times. We will show that the murder weapon was in Mr. Paris's possession at the time of his arrest and that it was covered with the blood type of Mr. Farley and also that of the defendant. And when all the testimony is in and the evidence is before you, it will show beyond a reasonable doubt that Joe Paris is guilty of the cold-blooded murder of Jacob Farley. Thank you.
Does the defense wish to make an opening statement?
We do, Your Honor, but we reserve opening until the government has concluded its case.
State calls Matthew Farley.
Matthew Farley.
Matt, will you please tell the court your experience the night of September the 23rd?
23rd was a Wednesday. Every Wednesday we went to this little fish place for dinner. My sister Amy and I both went.
And on the night of the 23rd?
My father called from the club, said he couldn't make it.
Did he tell you why?
He said he was going to meet Joe Paris. He said Paris had been bugging him again, that it was time he dealt with the bastard once and for all.
Objection, hearsay, move to strike.
Sustained. The witness's last comment will be stricken from the record.
Did you recognize the name of Joe Paris?
Yeah. 6 months ago, Paris came into the club and got into a shouting fight with my father.
This Joe Paris that fought that night with your father in the club, can you identify him here in the courtroom?
Him.
Let the record show the witness pointed to the defendant.
We had a good band that night, but everybody was listening to the yelling at the entrance.
Do you recall what was yelled?
Yeah. He kept saying that my father wouldn't be around much longer.
How did you feel when you then heard that your father was going to meet Joe Paris on September the 23rd?
I was afraid for him.
Thank you. No further questions.
Mr. Farley, you know for a fact that your father actually met Mr. Paris on the night of the 23rd?
That's where he said he was going?
You do not know that he actually met Mr. Paris?
No.
Mr. Farley, what business was your father in?
He had a club.
Is this the same club that you yourself have now taken over?
Yeah.
You did not close it down at all for the funeral?
Objection.
Sustained, Counselor.
Since you have taken it over so easily, you must know a lot about your father's business. Did he ever do business with anyone else named Joe Paris?
No.
Do you know a Joe Parrish with an H?
Yeah.
Were you aware that Mr. Parrish owed your father a lot of money?
Objection. Not covered by direct.
Overruled. You may answer the question.
Well, Parrish didn't come down to the club, but that prick did.
Mr. Farley, this is a court of law. Choose your language accordingly.
Shall I repeat the question, Mr. Farley?
Look, lady, this is all lawyer bullshit.
Answer the question in good order, Mr.
Farley. Because I have a tape of Joe Paris, that Joe Paris, saying he's going to kill my father.
Objection, that's hearsay.
Mr. Farley, you will limit your answers to the question.
He didn't come home that night. I went down to the club. There were some tapes. One had Paris's name on it.
Potter!
Order! The witness's answer will be stricken from the record. And the jury is instructed to disregard his statements. Counsel may sidebar.
Your Honor, the district attorney said nothing about a tape during discovery.
We had no knowledge of any tape. I now want a warrant for possible admission into evidence.
Your Honor, I ask the tape not be admitted into evidence since it was not discovered prior to trial.
Denied. Where is the tape now, Mr. Farley?
At the club.
Your Honor, unless the state proves that this tape is authentic, I must ask for a mistrial. It is technically possible to re-edit a recording so that the intent of the person is completely taken out of context, or even contradicted.
That's true, Counselor. We'll recess to allow prosecution to secure the tape and test its authenticity.
All rise. Hear ye, hear ye, hear ye. All persons who have anything further to do before...
So, tell me about the tapes.
Well, I used to tape everything.
How?
Same way Nixon did. I think Jake got that club.
So the tapes are real?
She made a mistake, Farley, but you screw around with her and I'll take those goddamn tapes and I'll stick them up your ass. You got that?
We discussed this rationally, Joe.
No. How's this for rational? Give the lady back her money. Give me the tapes and get off her back. Otherwise, you know what I'll do.
What is Matt Farley doing something like that anyway?
Trying to find his father's murder?
We don't even know when it was recorded.
3784.
That's pretty stale. I mean, it's more prejudicial than probative.
It demonstrates defendant's motive.
Miss Hudson, I'm inclined to admit this tape. However, I will give you the opportunity to have it examined for authenticity by your own expert prior to my final ruling. Now, if you two will excuse me.
That's pretty dirty.
I told you, I didn't know anything about it. This is a big time, little girl. You want a high stakes, you got them.
Counsel?
Hudson? James Nix here. I'm afraid your client's been hiding things from you. You want to meet me at the Bay Tower room?
I was just on my way home, James.
This is documentary evidence that blows your case wide open. Now, you can learn about it in court tomorrow. That's fine with me.
I'll be there.
Seen your client's war record? He's a killer. Special Forces Phoenix program. Killed a lot of people in Vietnam. He strangled them. The same way he allegedly strangled Farley. He was trained for it.
You'll never get this into evidence. It's 18 years old.
Are you ready to talk a plea bargain now?
say, second degree? Maybe it wasn't premeditated. I mean, strangling evidently is second nature to this man.
It's circumstantial, and it doesn't prove a thing.
But you know what your problem is? You're too hungry. You want to make a name for yourself. And you think Joe Paris is your ticket.
There comes
a point when you've got to think about your client first. You can't win this. Murder 2 is the best you're going to do. You'll be out in 3 years unless he kills somebody else in the meantime. You better take him this offer.
Good night, James.
I'm going to nail your man, Hudson.
Yeah, Paris.
Yeah. Guess what? I just saw your war record.
What do you mean?
Jesus Christ, Joe.
I don't understand. I was in the war. What's the problem?
You are lying, that's what. You wanted to see me?
Yeah. What are you doing? Nick's told me offered a deal on the Paris case and you turned him down. Is that true?
I know what I'm doing.
Hudson, the man is as guilty as hell now. Who the fuck do you think you are, Anthony Bailey? You've got a man's life in your hands. Are you willing to take responsibility for a guilty verdict? Are you that sure of how well you'll do in a trial? You better be damn sure, Hudson. You know, one of the reasons I use old pros on cases like these is that they don't play God. Now, you take my advice, plead the case, and get it over with.
I did this. The door was open.
Just get out of here.
I think maybe I owe you an explanation.
Not now.
I didn't tell you about the war record because I didn't think it mattered.
Just like Lou's perjury didn't matter, Deborah Quinn didn't matter, and the tapes didn't matter. I need to believe in you, Joe. And I don't. You are lying to me.
I lied to keep somebody alive.
No more.
All right, come on. I'll tell you whatever you need to know.
No, I'll tell you what you need to know. Get out of my house now!
Is this it?
Yes!
She asked you to leave, dude.
This must be his Gucci-ness.
You know, I got a mind to bust you in the mouth.
Kyle, you don't want to do that.
Did you bring this trash into my house?
That's enough, both of you.
Now what?
Hey, what?
Got any new tapes, Joe?
What tapes?
I'd like to file a complaint.
Is his lawyer, too?
No, I'm his lawyer.
Well, who is he?
I live here.
Do you know this man?
I'd like to file a complaint.
Will you shut up,
What's a complaint?
The mink on his jockstrap is molding. You want to look into that?
Oh. He's clean.
Thanks. Now, what is your problem?
Who did it for you, Joe?
Did what? I want this conversation to take place somewhere else.
Well, talk to us and draw yourself a bath, huh?
That's enough, Paris.
You know, you're going to get clocked.
Shut up and listen. Somebody took a big interest in the tape collection at Farley's house. Helped himself to quite a few. No, it was not the dick-faced kid. He wasn't home. The alarm went off, so whoever it was didn't find out what he wanted. Obviously, he came here, too. Now, do you have any new information I should know about?
You do not have to answer that.
I don't believe this.
I think we're tailing anybody, Nick.
Yeah, why don't you search my house or search my car?
We have.
Oh. We were having a very nice conversation here, my attorney and I, before you came
in. If you don't mind, we'd like to continue.
It's your funeral. Have a nice evening.
Thank you.
By the way, he's offered you a deal.
Oh, yeah? What kind of deal?
Plea bargain, down to murder two, parole in 3 years.
Mind if I smoke?
No.
Yes? Don't you dare light that cigarette. He's lighting a cigarette.
Kyle, can we talk about this some other time?
What did the defendant, Joe Paris, say then?
He said that Farley had gone too far this time. Somebody's got to take him out.
And by take him out, do you understand what I mean?
Kill him.
So you heard Joe Paris on September the 21st predict that somebody was going to kill Jake Farley? That was 2 days before Mr. Farley was murdered?
Yeah.
I wonder how he knew that.
Objection.
Sustained, Mr. Nix.
I have no further questions.
Mr. Ruger, didn't you state your profession as cab driver?
Yeah, well, it's mainly cab driving.
But on occasion you have gone on errands for the deceased Mr. Farley?
Yeah, I go on errands for lots of people, including Joe when he was with the Boston PD. It's what I do.
Oh, come on, Mr. Ruger. I mean, you have been paid considerably more than cab fare for making certain deliveries to Mr. Farley's associates.
Your Honor, Mr. Ruger's not on trial here.
No one says he is. You may answer the question.
Yeah, I made deliveries to Farley's associates.
Have you ever heard any of these associates speak ill of Mr. Farley?
Speak ill of him? Yeah, well, they all spoke ill of him.
Have you ever heard any of them express the opinion that the world would be a better place with Mr. Farley removed from it?
I guess, yeah.
In fact, Mr. Ruger, have you ever heard Mr. Farley's son, Matthew Farley, express dissatisfaction with the way his father ran his business?
Farley was not very well liked.
Oh? Why?
He didn't run his life like it was a popularity contest, did he?
How did he run his life, Mr. Ruger? Did he ever double-cross a friend?
I guess, yeah.
Did he ever cheat an associate?
Yes.
Did he ever inform on fellow criminals?
Objection.
Did he ever inform on fellow business associates?
We need to hear your answer, Mr. Ruger.
Yeah, well, he ran and he stole anything to make a buck. I'm not telling you anything new.
Did he sell cocaine at his club?
Yeah.
Prostitutes at his club?
Yeah.
And did Jake Farley also blackmail people?
Your Honor, I object.
Let me rephrase the question. Mr. Ruger, did Jake Farley ever blackmail you?
You didn't tell me this was going to happen.
Your Honor.
Order. Witness will answer the question.
Yeah, he had stuff on me.
You mean he blackmailed you?
Yeah.
Mr. Ruger, have you ever said anything unkind, hateful, or derogatory about Jake Farley?
Yes. Everybody I know did.
Now, Mr. Ruger, considering everything you and other people have said about Jake Farley, were the comments of Joe Paris anywhere near as strong as the others?
Not really, no.
Thank you. No further questions.
Witness may step down.
Your Honor, may we sidebar?
Yes, Counselor.
Last night, the state gained new evidence which shed significant light on this case.
Your Honor, it's inadmissible.
If you'll notice, paragraph 3 here, the underlying part.
I can read, Mr. Nix.
Yes, Your Honor.
This thing is nearly 20 years old.
Yes, Your Honor. But it shows a man's a war hero.
You want to enter that into your case?
It shows a pattern, a specific method of killing.
Were you ever in the service, Mr. Nix?
No, Your Honor.
Take this away, if you don't mind.
Keep such hot shit.
Scott, something.
Farley, you had better get out of here.
You know, you think you're so
serious trouble.
You think you're so high and mighty. You think you can do anything you want. You're trying to ruin my reputation and ruin my club.
Club?
There's Mrs. Dying because of your little act. I got nobody in there because of you and your Joe Paris.
Mr. Farley, this is not the way to handle
things. Look, I know how to handle things. I've handled everything so far. Just you remember, lady. I know how to handle things.
Yes?
What's going on? Who's this? No, what do you want?
Please.
You got some business here?
Yeah.
Huh? You got some business? The woman's a vulture, man. She lives off dead meat.
Get out.
She's garbage.
Get out of here.
Riley, okay. Did you see that? He tried to kill me.
Come on, please.
Who the hell was that?
It's Farley's son.
I'm going to sue the bastard.
Come in.
God. Is this worth it?
What
is this? Dealing with the scum that you do every day. You don't need this, and I don't need it either.
I know. I'm really, really sorry.
You broke my Rolex.
Witnesses for the defense will show that many individuals had both motive and opportunity to kill Jake Farley. The testimony will show that an array of criminals had made vows of revenge against Joe Paris for his key role in putting them behind bars. Many of these are convicted murderers with a grudge against Jake Farley as well. But we do not have to prove Joe was framed. He remains innocent until the prosecution proves him guilty. Please, always remember that, ladies and gentlemen, while we present an alibi witness who will testify that Joe Paris was nowhere near the scene of Jake Farley's murder. And this witness has a lot to lose by coming forth. The defense calls Deborah Quinn.
Deborah Quinn?
I thought we were going to involve her.
We have no choice, Joe.
Raise your right hand. Do you swear that the testimony you are about to give is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
We can't hear you, ma'am.
Yes, I do. Could you please state your name and address?
Deborah Quinn, 831 Hillside Park.
Ms. Quinn, how long have you known the defendant?
Almost 2 years.
Could you please describe your relationship with him?
We're friends. Good friends.
On the night of September 23rd, could you please describe what you did starting about 5 p.m.?
On the night of September 23rd?
Yes.
Well, on the night of September 23rd, I was...
Go on. Miss Quinn.
I was with my husband, Vincent.
Your Honor, I move for a mistrial.
Denied?
Your Honor, the district attorney must know what's going on by bringing in this woman's husband.
Order. Your motion has been denied, Counselor.
I move for a brief recess.
Any objection, Mr. Nix? Then, considering the hour, and with the holiday coming up, this court will adjourn for 3 days, next to resume this coming Tuesday.
All rise. Hear ye, hear ye, hear ye.
She's a dead woman.
We have until next Tuesday to solve a big problem, because right now we have no case.
She's a dead woman, and you just killed her, and what's more, you don't give a damn.
You're my client, Dick Tracy.
Not anymore.
Fine.
At present, depart. God save the Commonwealth of Massachusetts.
Minya, no.
Miss Hudson, Vincent Quinn, Deborah's husband.
I wonder if I might speak to Deborah for a moment.
Oh, of course you can, but I think you might be interested to know that my wife has told me everything about her friendship with your client. It was a long time ago, before she met me. And of course she'd want to testify on his behalf at the trial. However, I cannot allow her to perjure herself.
I wouldn't want her to either.
Miss Hudson, please. My wife told me about your idea to get your client off with a phony alibi.
My idea?
She couldn't possibly have been with your client that night because she was with me.
I thought you were out of town.
That's right. We were. At the Chicago Hyatt.
Both of you?
Both of us. And I assure you proper documentation could be provided if necessary. Now, if there is anything else we can do, please, don't hesitate to call. Sweetheart?
Wrong now.
What do you mean?
This case is starting to consume you. I don't like what you're becoming.
And what am I becoming that is so intolerable?
Manish.
Spanish?
Yeah.
Just because I'm doing things my way now? Or is it because I'm involved with something that's more important than your almighty stock swindles?
That's uncalled for. What are you talking about?
Oh, come off it, Kyle! You look down on street people like Joe as though what you are doing isn't corruption. What do you call junk bonds, sweetheart?
Junk bonds? What?
You hide behind carefully worded SEC boilerplate.
Oh?
And you sell shit to the public any idiot can see will never be paid back.
Shit!
But your hands are clean. Because a battalion of corporate lawyers keeps you moral pricks out of jail.
Really? You feel better? After all I've done for you?
I suppose you found me in the gutter, Kyle. And I should be so grateful for everything you've done for me.
No, I just don't think you should be ungrateful. You know, there are lots of women who'd love to be in your shoes.
You get one.
Oh. Wait a minute, Jenzer.
Sit me along with a pole pony!
You know something? You're the snob, not me. You think some unwashed, has-been detective killer is somehow morally superior to me.
I think everyone is morally superior to you, Kyle.
You can't think the competition, can you? Because I'm successful and you're not, you resent me. Think about it.
You're right, Kyle. You're too good for me. I'm moving out.
Be ridiculous.
I am so tired of being ridiculous. We're through. I won't be needing those anymore anyway. I'm off the case.
Are broken.
No kidding. Leave him alone.
All right. Better call a doctor.
How many you got for me today, Strickler? A full gross, Farley. I'll take refrigerators and microwaves. I'll give you $2,000.
Well, this stuff's worth $5,000. Fence it yourself, officer. Make it $2,500, Farley.
Shit, to stay in business. I'm doing you a favor moving this stuff. $2,000. Take it or leave it.
Okay.
Go for it, you son of a bitch.
Okay, relax. Relax, Joe. Relax. What are you doing, man? Would you just calm down?
Joe, this has got nothing to do with you.
Come on!
All I wanted was this. This is old news, Joe. I've been straight for 10 years.
Bullshit! Then listen to me!
It was one thing for Farley to blackmail me, but now his fucking kid has taken over. Only the kid wants twice what the old man collected. He wanted to take over the business, and he couldn't wait, so he killed his old man.
Give me the tape.
Okay.
I'm gonna put a hole in your head!
It slipped, man. I swear to God, it slipped. I didn't kill him, Joe. It wasn't me.
What are you doing here?
I'm on fire in you.
Oh, why?
Sometimes I can be a bit of an asshole. Look, I didn't do it.
You didn't, did you?
I need your help.
I need yours.
Where do you want these?
Anywhere. Deborah says she was in Chicago with her husband the night Farley was killed.
Sure.
I understand your feelings about Deborah, but I think she and her husband are involved in this. Couples talk. There's no telling how much.
What I know about Vincent, he didn't do it.
Unless he had a personal reason.
You're fishing.
Yeah, I guess.
What are you doing?
I'm moving out.
Oh, yeah? About time.
I don't want to talk about it.
Good, I don't want to talk about it either.
I was married once, in the Peace Corps. Except Donald decided to play ambassador of love to every woman in Costa Rica. Kind of a one-man goodwill tour. So I finally divorced him.
Why are you telling me this?
I guess I just want you to understand all this.
Got a place to stay tonight?
My sister has her bedroom.
It's lucky.
This is for Jennifer Hudson. My name's Tony Sklar. I have information you might be able to use. I would like to discuss with you the value of such information. I'm going to be at the Walpole State Prison Infirmary. Get here after visiting hours tonight. Ask for the warden. Don't bring any other person or any recording device, or the whole deal is off.
I know that guy. The pathological liar.
It's a lead, Joe.
Nowhere.
I'm gonna go check it out.
Okay.
I'd die.
Suicide twice this month. I think he's just trying to get away from the population. Of course, you can't be sure. He's a pretty unstable character. You know his history, don't you? I'll give you 10 minutes.
I'm safe. I thought you'd be older.
What is it you had to tell me?
I can get your client off, but I want a deal.
What deal?
I just lost an appeal. Looks like I'm going to be in here another 30 years. I got a wife and kid I want them taken care of. And I want some leniency for me.
You must know I'm in no position to make deals.
You got influence, you can do something.
I need to know what you got.
Ever hear of Harry Norton? Your client sent him away on a conspiracy to commit murder rap.
We checked him out. He was in Rio at the time of the murder.
Of course he was. Listen to me. Norton had a beautiful chick at the time he went in the joint. Name of Celeste. 4 years into Norton's sentence, Celeste up and marries our friend Farley. You'd never think a prick like Norton could get his heart broken. I mean, here's a guy who can have anybody off long distance, in jail or out. But he couldn't control his woman. And that made him crazy. And it was your client who sent him up and cut his balls off. Now, I'm in here because I've been accused of the double murder of federal witnesses. I'm not saying I did those. But I will say I have made hits a state doesn't know about. Norton hired me to kill Farley and his bride, Celeste. I set up an accident. I got Celeste, but Farley survived. Car accident on the Cape. It was yours truly. I was supposed to let things cool and go back and finish Farley. I never got the chance. I came here instead.
Who did Norton hire this time?
Give me a good reason to tell you.
Mr. Scolari.
Please, tell me.
You realize your credibility isn't the greatest.
I know, but what can you do?
I need proof.
I have proof.
I need to see it.
That can be arranged.
I'll see what I can do.
Counselor, do us both a favor. Don't go sniffing around for your mystery man without checking with me first. You might hurt yourself.
Listen, I have a witness who's willing to testify that he was hired to kill Farley and his wife. He'll name who hired him. This guy succeeded on Celeste. That auto accident was no accident.
Reputable witness?
Mr. Fabrication, did he show you any swamp land down in Florida?
He wants to make a deal.
Sure he does. The guy's a known liar.
Offering proof, but he won't give it without some kind of a deal.
I don't deal with scum. This guy is septic tank material.
Help me buy time. Tell me you'll support negotiations if he delivers.
You're reaching.
He's offering exculpatory evidence. Don't obstruct that.
The word of a known liar does not qualify as evidence.
You can't suppress this, Nix. Help me make a deal.
You had your chance.
I'm inclined to grant counsel for the defense adequate time to investigate this witness's potential. We'll adjourn for one day, pending possible new evidence for the defense. But if that should fail, I'll want closing arguments in 48 hours.
Hey, Sklar, telephone. It's that lawyer.
Hudson.
Hello, Tony.
Hello?
Ask.
sleeps.
Hold. This is Tony. I'm gonna get you, asshole.
Amazing. Hello.
This is Tony. I'm gonna get you, asshole.
Look, I don't know what your game is, Tony, but you can't pin anything on me.
Officer Strickler, this is Jennifer Hudson.
You better watch out, lady, because you could get real hurt. Interesting. Talk to Sklar again.
He has nothing further to say to you.
Yeah, I got plenty to say to him. I had nothing to do with that hit on him.
How did you know about the hit?
I read the Herald like any good citizen.
Brady was not identified in the Herald.
No, don't give me that shit. I can put two and two together. I know a setup when I see one and I'm not buying.
You have been positively identified and now Mr. Sklar wants satisfaction.
He's full of shit. Both full of shit.
Nice job. Let's see if he buys it.
Boys in blue.
Man. Hey, Joe, how's it going?
Hey, Joe. Hi, guys.
We're at prison from the DA.
We want it. Protection. Nick's order. Can I see you?
You owe me $2.
Is Nick's in? It's Jennifer Hudson. James, we do not want any protection. Because we want to do things our own way, and you're interfering, plain and simple. Yeah. He wants to talk to you.
No problem, sir. Yes, sir. He says we're to keep you on our sights, but you can stick us where you want.
How about Cleveland?
It isn't working.
You relax.
Stop with you.
Too late now.
What?
What?
What, you're not going to Ned's wedding?
No.
Why not?
Well, because of David once named once.
You went out with Mandy?
Yeah.
When was this?
About 6 months ago.
Hey, who's that?
Looks like Wilkinson.
Nah, Wilkinson's on vacation.
Well, where'd he go?
Someplace with his mother. You know Wilkinson.
Who is this guy?
No, no, no. Hey, buddy, how's it going?
Get started.
What?
Give me the keys to the restaurant. Stay upstairs.
Thank you.
Jesus, Joe, can't you do anything right?
Mm-hmm.